With a simple flip, you can turn on the nightstand. With a flip of a 180, I can turn on the fan.
And with a simple shake, I can turn on the backdrop. And that is just a few things that this amazing device can do. And it's called the Aqara Cube. Welcome friends, if this is your first time here and you're into smart home automation and products and reviews, you're definitely in the right place. For full disclosure, Aqara did send this out to me for a full honest review. But if something is wrong, I'm definitely gonna let you know. I'll be leaving affiliate links down below and a full pros and cons list on my website, so definitely check that out. Now currently, the Aqara Cube only works within the Aqara app. It is not exposed to HomeKit, so unfortunately it will only work with other Aqara products currently, but there are ways around it. I'm going to have some friends show you how you can get this to work with some HomeKit accessories in just a moment. The Aqara Cube is a Zigbee device, which means that you will need the Aqara Hub to make this work. Unfortunately, this is an additional item. I think it costs like 50 or 60 bucks, and it is required. To set this up, go into the Aqara app, press the plus in the top right corner, go down to plugs and switches, scroll down to the cube, and it's going to bring up your hub. The name of my hub is called Security System. Once you press this, it will say
ready to connect to child devices.
You will have to open this up with the provided tool and hold down the reset button for about 5 seconds and it will connect. Now once this is connected, you can go ahead and set this up with other Aqara products by going to the automations down at the bottom, press the plus in the top right corner, and this is just a normal if this then that statement. So go into if, hit add, and you scroll down to the cube, and you're gonna say what you want the trigger to be. Here, I'm just gonna do a simple 90 degree flip, and then you can easily add this command to any other Aqara product. So for instance, you have the Aqara plug, which is called the family room lights. I can turn it on, turn it off, or do an on off statement, which is a condition statement, meaning that if it's off, if I flip it, it's going to turn on, and if I flip it again, it's going to turn off depending on the current condition, which is really cool. You really don't have that within HomeKit. You can also control Aqara switches, which I reviewed last week. If you haven't seen that video, definitely check it out. But that's all you can really do within Aqara.
But to get this to work with other HomeKit accessories, it is definitely a little bit harder. There is an easy way and a hard way. So first up, I'm going to have my friend Shane Watley show you the easy way and how he got his cube to work with one trigger within HomeKit. Shane, turn it over to you.
Yo, what's up, Eric? Thanks for having me. Yeah, man, as you know, I like to keep my HomeKit setup as simple and easy as possible. But that's why I was playing around with this cube one day and came up with a really easy way to get it to control my HomeKit lights. So what we're going to do in this one is basically use a Aqara smart plug to act as a bridge kind of between this and our HomeKit lights. The Aqara smart plug, this came as a part of that Aqara starter kit, you know, on Amazon, or you can just buy them individually as well. But let's go ahead and set this up. It's really easy. I'll show you how I did it. First, let's open up the Aqara app, choose the automations tab, and we're going to do a new automation here. We're going to select the cube, flip 90 degrees, and then we're going to choose what it does. So we're going to have this control our smart plug here. And now you can use any Aqara accessory in here that you can control, such as the hub light, or if you have some of the new wall switches, basically anything you can control in here, you can then have it control in HomeKit as long as that's exposed to HomeKit as well. So we're going to do the smart plug and we're going to choose the turn on and off. That way we can create a toggle with this flip. All right, choose save. I'm going to name it Cube 90. Confirm. All right, there we go. That's our first automation in the Aqara app. That was easy. Now let's go to the home app. Go over to your automations tab. We're going to do a new automation here. Choose accessories controlled. Let's scroll down. We're going to find our smart plug that we're controlling. For me, it's this one right here. This is my Aqara smart plug. And I'm going to choose when this turns on. And I'm going to control these lights back here. These are some HomeKit lights. And we're going to have them turn on when the outlet turns on. Okay, easy enough. Now we're gonna do one more automation, kind of the reverse of that. So when that outlet turns off, choose next. We're going to turn the lights off. Background lights, turn off, done. All right, and that's it. It's really that simple. So now when I rotate this, it's gonna toggle my smart outlet on or off. And then depending on whether that's on or off, it's gonna change my HomeKit lights behind me. So let's give it a shot. Rotate 90 degrees. There you go, the lights turned off. Let's rotate it one more time. And they're on. There you go, it's as simple as that. That is a really easy way to use the Aqara Cube to control your HomeKit lights. All right, Eric, thanks again for having me, man. Back to you.
Thanks, Shane. That was really cool. I love the simplicity of how to get this into HomeKit. Super easy. If you guys are into HomeKit, you definitely have to subscribe to Shane Whatley. He does all HomeKit products and reviews and how-tos. Definitely go over down below. Check out his channel. There will be a link down below. Now, next up is a little bit more advanced option. If you guys want to have all the triggers to work within HomeKit, it's a little bit more advanced, but it can definitely be done. So my friend Shay, she's going to show you how to do that.
Thanks, Eric. Thanks, Shane. I'm going to demo a different way to set up the cube. And what you'll do is just repeat this process for each gesture or action that you want to set up. So let's start in the Aqara app. From the bottom menu, select accessories, then tap on Aqara Hub. You'll see the color scenes at the bottom. Tap plus to add one. Then you can just drag the circle to select a color. And the outer dial controls the brightness. And then just type in a scene name. Wax on, because I'm going to turn on this wax warmer behind me. Then confirm and save. Then back out of there. And then from the bottom menu, select automation. Tap the plus sign. We're going to add. This is just an if-then statement. So from the if at the top, select add, then the cube, and let's just do shake. And then in the bottom half, the then, there's also an add, tap that. Select Aqara Hub, turn on nightlight, add Aqara Hub. And then at the bottom, set as the assigned scene, we're gonna use that scene we just set up. So for me, wax on, add. I'm gonna add a small delay to make sure this setting happens. I'm just gonna do 5, you can do less, play around with it. Add, and then we need a default to set it back to. So I'm going to select Aqara Hub and then set as the assigned scene. I just use wake. There's 4 default scenes, you can use any of them. And then add another delay, and then add Aqara Hub, turn off nightlight, and then save. We'll name it, and then just make sure that your nightlight is on the hub before you exit out. We're gonna go into the Eve app, and then from the bottom, select room, select the room that your hub is in, and let's make sure that it's set to that color. If it's not, then back out, go to the Apple Home app, pull it up in there, and that should reset it, and then you can come back into the Eve app. Okay, so now that I've verified that, I'm going to select automation from the bottom menu. Let's set up the scene first. Okay, this is what we want to happen. So let's select edit from the upper right and then add scene, add action. I'm going to select this room and then turn on the wax warmer, add. Next, and you're just gonna give it a name and then select an icon, done. Okay, then go ahead and tap done. And then from the top menu, select rules and then add rule, tap on trigger, add trigger, other value. Remember, it's the nightlight that's driving this. Scroll down to the room with the nightlight, slide power to on, add, next, add value condition. Select it again, and this time slide color, saturation, and brightness to on, and it should pick up that color scene. And tap add. Next, here's where you're going to select that scene. Next, and then just enter a name for the rule. This will show up over in the automations in the Apple Home app, and the scene we've set up will show up in the room. Okay, let's go verify this over in the Apple Home app. I can see the scene was set up, so now I'm just gonna tap on automation and verify that I see that rule that I had set up. And then let's go on out and we will go over to the Aqara Home app, and I'm just going to go ahead and set my hub nightlight back to my default scene and turn it off before I try this. Okay, I'm gonna demo the actions I have set up. Let's go with the shake. turns on the wax warmer. And then there's this gold floor lamp back here. A slide will turn that on. And this is hard to see, let me this up a little bit. Then if I just do a flip 90 degrees, that'll turn on the smaller one next to it. Okay. And then the Eve flare, I'm gonna do a 180. Sometimes the Eve is a little slow to come on. Okay, let's try it again. There it goes. Okay, so that's it. Just repeat those steps for each gesture you'd like to set up on the cube. Thank you.
Thanks, Shay. That's really cool. I love how you are able to get all the triggers and gestures over to HomeKit. Even though that it's not natively exposed to HomeKit, you got it done. So job well done. If you guys are into HomeKit, smart home automation, advanced programming, you definitely want to check out Shay's channel. I'll leave a card up there and a link down in the description to check it out. So overall, the Cube is pretty cool. It's definitely a very, I would call it a novelty item. It's not something you should rely on to turn on, smart home automation all the time. Unfortunately, there are hiccups from time to time. Maybe you just don't hit it down hard enough. It's not registering the right gesture. It does happen, so you can't rely upon it. Plus, the rotate gesture does not work whatsoever. I'll let Aqara know, and if they do update that and fix that issue, I'll update my full pros and cons list on my website, so definitely check that out. I want to thank Shay and Shane for being in this video and showing us how to hook this up within HomeKit. If you guys want to check out their channels, I'll leave links down below. If you guys want to see the next video in my HomeKit series, click that video right there. And if you're brand new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and I will see you on next video. Thanks for watching. Nothing can break me.